Our next item of business is a debate on a short debate on motion 24246 in the name of Bill Kidd on standing order rule changes, inquiry into the resilience of the Scottish Parliament's practices and procedures in relation to its business. Could I invite any member who wishes to contribute, press their buttons. Can I begin by asking Bill Kidd to speak to and move the motion. Mr. Kidd.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. A very short debate, so don't worry. Following the introduction of lockdown provisions almost a year ago, the Scottish Parliament adapted its practices and procedures to ensure that the Parliament was able to meet. Since April last year, it has met in a mix of virtual, hybrid and socially distanced formats to ensure that parliamentary business can continue, with technology developed to allow us to participate in parliamentary votes via a virtual platform. The SPPA Committee's inquiry looked at how other legislatures had adapted to the COVID pandemic, and it was clear that the Scottish Parliament has been one of the best in ensuring that committee and plenary meetings can continue to take place, that almost all types of parliamentary business can continue, and that MSPs can vote both in the chamber and in committees. The committee considered that this was a major achievement and a testament to the commitment and flexibility of members, the parliamentary authorities, and particularly parliamentary staff. The committee's inquiry into the resilience of the Scottish Parliament considered what permanent changes were needed to standing orders to ensure that the Scottish Parliament could continue to meet in the face of any future challenges. In its report, the committee recommends that a new rule should be introduced to allow for temporary rule changes to be made to standing orders for a limited time period. This will provide greater flexibility for the Parliament, as it will be able to agree more substantial changes to the rules in a shorter period of time. In addition, the committee recommends that a number of permissive changes be made to allow for virtual and hybrid meetings of the Chamber and of committees, and for virtual voting in both the Chamber and committees. It will be for the Session 6 Parliament, once social distancing no longer constrains the ability of Parliament to meet physically, to consider in what circumstances virtual or hybrid meetings should take place in the future. I move that the Parliament notes the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee's second report 2021, Session 5, Standing Order Rule Changes, Inquiry into the Resilience of the Scottish Parliament's Practices and Procedures in Relation to Its Business, SP Paper 953, and agrees that A, the rule change on the temporary amendment to standing orders be made with effect from 8 March 2021, and B, all remaining rule changes set out in Annex A be made with effect from 12th of May 2021. Thank you very much.
Mr. Kidd, thank you very much indeed. No other member has indicated they wish to contribute. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of Business Motion 24274 in the name of Graeme Day on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. Could I call on Graeme Day to move this motion?
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much. And no member has indicated they wish to speak. The question, therefore, is that Motion 24274 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We are agreed. Thank you. The next item is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 24275 on campaign recess. Could I call on Graeme Day on behalf of the Bureau to move this motion?
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. Could I call on James Kelly to speak? James Kelly.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I wish to speak in opposition to Parliamentary Bureau Motion S5M24275. The motion is titled Campaign Recess, but the essential point in it is that it effectively brings forward the closure of the Office of the Clerk, which restricts, inhibits in fact, MSPs from submitting written parliamentary questions. I think the important thing to understand about the period that we enter is that although we head towards an election, we've not got a dissolution as would normally happen, but we're moving into a period of recess, and all MSPs will continue in post until May the 5th. the government, understandably, because there's a pandemic ongoing, will be dealing with issues around that. All MSPs continue to get multiple requests around issues, for example, like vaccine rollout, businesses that are struggling with support, people who are unsure about their job prospects, and pupils and parents with concerns about the ongoing issues in the education system. It's important that MSPs are able to continue to submit questions to government ministers and to hold government ministers to account. Those in the office of the clerk, and indeed stopping the ability to submit written questions from next Thursday, the 11th of March, restricts this. It restricts MSPs and their ability to do their job representing their constituents and also holding the government to account. As such, Scottish Labour are not able to endorse this motion tonight.
Thank you very much, Mr Kelly. Could I call on the Minister, Graham Day, to speak?
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Bureau has considered the implications of the Scottish General Election Coronavirus Act on parliamentary business on a number of occasions. In December last year, it agreed that any business during the short campaign period should be limited to only matters that are absolutely necessary in response to the pandemic. This agreement is consistent with the purposes of the Act and the elections guidance from the SPCB, which anticipates that the Parliament would not meet during the short campaign period unless for emergency reasons. It is intended to help ensure that parliamentary resources are not used for any party political or election campaigning activity and that all candidates are treated the same during what would normally be a period of dissolution, while at the same time allowing for the Parliament to be called in an emergency. The Bureau therefore agreed to propose to Parliament that we should go into recess during this period with the usual option of recall where necessary. But essentially, Presiding Officer, this is a recess period, not a dissolution, for one primary purpose, and that is to ensure that if it became necessary to cancel the election because of an escalation in the pandemic, the members of Parliament could return to take that decision. The proposal was unanimously agreed to by the Parliament on the 17th of February 2021. The Bureau recognised that all members will be aware of the policies that restrict the use of parliamentary resources during the short campaign period. However, it was also agreed to look at further procedural steps to limit what business could be transacted while allowing, if necessary, business in relation to the pandemic to take place. In considering possible steps, the Bureau was conscious of balancing the interests of providing flexibility for any necessary scrutiny to take place against the limitations of the short campaign period. It is for that reason that an exception is proposed to enable the COVID-19 committee to meet in an emergency, i.e. if it considers this to be necessary. To be clear, Scottish ministers must ensure the lifting of any restrictions no longer necessary to protect public health. They are required to do this. But if changes were made which the COVID-19 committee felt were significant enough to invite its attention, it could sit and the government would provide a minister to attend. And of course, Presiding Officer, you retain the power to recall Parliament during any period it is in recess, although, as you have indicated previously, there would have to be a very high bar set for you to interrupt the election recess period. Presiding Officer, I would summarise matters in the following way. This Parliament is far from unable to hold ministers to account during the pre-election period, but a sensible, proportionate approach is being taken to ensure that is the case, in keeping with other decisions taken previously by the Parliamentary Bureau. Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Minister. And the question on this motion will be taken at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of 5 Parliamentary Bureau motions. Could I call on Graham Day once more on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move motions 24276, 24280, sorry, 24276 to 24280 on approval of SSIs.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much. So we turn to decision time. The first question is that motion 24247 in the name of Lewis MacDonald on what should primary care look like for the next generation be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We are agreed. The next question is the amendment 24263.2 in the name of Jamie Hepburn, which seeks to amend motion 24263 in the name of Monica Lennon on Scotland's recovery be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
were not agreed. We're going to move to a division. This is the first division of the day. Therefore, we're going to suspend business for a few moments just to allow members in the chamber and elsewhere to access the voting app. Parliament is suspended for a few moments. Thank you, colleagues. That is us back in session. So we're going to go straight to the vote. And the question is that Amendment 242.63.2 in the name of Jamie Hepburn, which seeks to amend Motion 24263 in the name of Monica Lennon on Scotland's recovery be agreed. Members may press their votes now. And this is a one-minute division. 1 minute on the amendment in the name of Jamie Hepburn.
Have you actually got somebody lined up for the next?
Thank you, colleagues. That vote is now closed. Please let me know if you were not able to vote. Thank you. The result of the vote on amendment number 24263.2 in the name of Jamie Hepburn is yes 84, no 33. There were no abstentions. The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that amendment 24263.1 in the name of Maurice Golden, which seeks to amend motion 24263 in the name of Monica Lennon, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
We're not agreed. We'll move to a division. This will be a 1 minute division on the amendment in the name of Maurice Golden. That vote is now closed. Please let me know if you had any issues. The result of the vote on amendment number 24263.1 in the name of Maurice Golden is yes 29, no 89. There were no abstentions. The amendment is therefore not agreed. The next question is that motion 24263 in the name of Monica Lennon as amended on Scotland's recovery be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We're not agreed. We'll move to a vote. Members may cast their votes now. This is a 1 minute division again. 1 minute on the amended motion in the name of Monica Lennon. Thank you. That vote is now closed. Please let me know if you were not able to vote. Can I call Jenny Mara to make a point of order? Jenny Mara.
Presiding officer, I'm sorry my app wouldn't connect. I would have voted yes.
Thank you very much, Ms. Manna. I'll make sure your vote is added. Thank you very much. Thank you. The result of the vote on motion 24263 in the name of Monica Lennon as amended is yes 84, no 34. There were no abstentions. The motion as amended is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 24246 in the name of Bill Kidd on standing order rule changes, inquiry into the resilience of the Scottish Parliament's practices and procedures in relation to its business be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We are agreed. The next question is that motion 24275 in the name of Graham Day on campaign recess be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We're not agreed. We'll move to a vote. This will be a 1 minute vote on the motion on campaign recess. Members may vote now. That vote is now closed. Please let me know if you were not able to vote. Thank you. The result of the vote on motion 24275 in the name of Graham Day on behalf of the Bureau is yes 95, no 1. There were 21 abstentions. The motion is therefore agreed. And the final question is that motions 24276 to 24280 in the name of Graham Day on approval of SSIs be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
We are agreed, and that concludes decision time. We're going to move shortly to members' business, but in the meantime, could I encourage all members who are leaving to follow the one-way systems, wear their masks, and observe social distancing rules. Thank you.